Hey y'all, it's Jess. Welcome back to Roots and Refuge Farm. I'm in my kitchen and today I'm going to be covering a topic that we've been kind of mentioning but I haven't done a comprehensive video about, and that is juicing. So we are not new to juicing. We were introduced to it several years ago. However, over the last couple of months, Jeremiah and I have kind of made some personal resolves that we're really going to address some bad eating habits that we have and really focus on eating real food, kicking the sugar habit, just completely cutting out convenience foods and any sort of fast food. And the one big thing that's helping make that possible for us is juicing. Many of you have noticed that we've both lost weight, that our skin is looking great, that we look healthier, and you know, it's obvious that we feel really great. And I really largely attribute that to using our juicer every day to juice fruits and vegetables. Now, we were introduced to juicing about 7 years ago. There was a documentary called Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead that we watched on Netflix. I'm sure it's available somewhere online, but basically the premise of the video is that it followed the story of a guy named Joe who was overweight, who was having some really serious health issues, and he needed like a total overhaul. He needed to do something drastic to get his health in check. And so he did like a really long 40 or 60 day juice cleanse where he consumed nothing but freshly juiced fruits and vegetables. And they documented the process, they documented his weight loss, his cholesterol levels going down, just overall his energy going up and showing how much better he felt. And it kind of started a movement, I guess, and a lot of people started juicing at that time, just brought a lot of awareness to it. And at the end of his journey, he then reintroduced a healthy diet. I think he stayed vegetarian, but he did start eating again. Juicing is not a long-term, like, you can't stand alone juice for a long-term period. It's not a lifestyle. However, for us, integrating juices in with an overall diet of real food, it has so many benefits. Before I get to those, I guess let me just address the naysayers. I've noticed a lot that whenever someone starts having a lot of success in something and they're like, hey, I'm doing keto, or I'm going vegan, or I'm doing Whole30, or I'm juicing, or whatever, there are a lot of people being like, you know, that's bad for you because XYZ. And there are arguments for and against every diet style that there is. I think that we all probably need to just agree on the fact that the standard American diet is no good, that eating fast food, being addicted to sugar, and eating food on the regular that is so full of ingredients that you can't pronounce is killing people. It's causing an epidemic of obesity and disease, and we should stop doing that. And so my take on it is kind of like, whatever it is helping you to make a lifestyle choice to a place of eating clean, real food, do that. And if that is keto or vegan or Whole30 or juicing, whatever that is, do that. Because truly, no matter how you get there, eating real whole foods, that's going to be better for you than being addicted to sugar, soda, into the fast food drive-through window. And so I'm not really interested in arguing over whether juicing is the very best thing. I'm just telling you what's worked for me. And it has. It really has worked for us. Now, the idea of juicing is that you take a juicer, which I will show you guys ours here in a minute, and you put vegetables and fruits through it, and it removes the fiber and the pulp and leaves you with juice. This is a recipe that we use, and I'll also share this with you. And basically the idea of this is that you now have all of the nutrients, all of the enzymes, all of the minerals that existed in those vegetables here in this juice. It does not have the fiber in it, and basically you're able to absorb and assimilate this into your body without your digestive system having to work really hard in order to process that stuff. So it rests your digestive system and it fuels your body in a really intense way. Now, you do need fiber. Fiber is important. You can't just stop eating fiber. That would be bad. And that is one of the reasons why juicing alone as a long-term thing is not it's not a feasible option. However, for us, what we have found is that waking up in the morning and making 32 ounces of juice just like this and starting our day with this, we just don't eat breakfast, this is breakfast. What has happened is that our body is at that point, it's so fueled, it's been given all these minerals and all of these vitamins and all of this nutrition that it's able to absorb and put into process. And so we're not starting our day with sugar or carbs and starting our day with cravings for those things. We're basically starting our day fueled and ready to go. Because of the fact that the fiber is removed, like I said, your body doesn't have to work on getting the good stuff out of those vegetables. Now you should still eat vegetables and that's still good for you. But this is basically, there's more fruits and vegetables in this jar of juice. There's more nutrition from that much fruits and vegetables than I could sit down and eat. There are a lot of things that kind of come up, I guess arguments for juicing, about how it lowers cholesterol, helps your immune system, and you'll hear kind of a lot of miracle claims. And even though I'm a huge fan of juicing and a huge advocate for juicing, and I would love to see more people adding this tool to their tool belt, standing alone, I don't think that juicing is necessarily like a miracle thing. I don't think that you could juice every morning and still live through the fast food window and experience as many benefits. Now, you would experience more benefits than if you were just living through the fast food window. If you were just eating garbage food, juicing on top of that would be giving that nutrition to your body. And for a lot of people, I say, hey, why don't you add this in and address those other food habits later? But when you start with this, I think it does something really cool, and this is one of the benefits that I find in being a person who, I have had some bad eating habits in my life. My issue is not like binge eating so much or, you know, like super addictive habits. I'm pretty good at breaking those things, but I'm really bad about getting super busy and not eating until I'm driving somewhere, and then all of a sudden I'm like, oh wow, I haven't eaten all day, I'm starving, fast food it is. You do that enough and basically you just have a really, you know, poor nutrition. And for me, regularly juicing every single morning, I'm fueling my body in such a positive way that if I did end up going through the fast food window, it was obvious how bad it made me feel. You know, you can get so used to eating poorly that you don't realize how much of a detriment it is to you. Because you just get used to being tired. You get used to crashing at 3 o'clock every afternoon. You get used to feeling depressed. You get used to just feeling kind of lethargic because you're used to it. However, whenever you start juicing regularly and then you do end up going through that fast food window and you feel like you have a rock in your gut, it's like, oh wow, this really is bad for me. You can feel it more because you're setting a baseline for what your body is actually supposed to feel like when it's properly fueled. Of course, there is the benefit of weight loss. That is a real benefit. Again, you're gonna experience those benefits of the lower cholesterol and the higher immune system and the weight loss when you're doing an overall change. And for us, we started like seriously doing this every single morning, I think probably about 2.5 months ago. We started drinking juice every morning. Sometimes we go ahead and drink in the evening too, and we just won't eat dinner. And we usually eat at least one good meal every day. And I think Jeremiah's down about 25 pounds. I've lost about 12 or so. It's been a little bit slower for me, but I've lost a lot of inches. And overall, we feel fantastic. I used to deal with a lot of like bloating and swelling and puffiness. I used to have stomach aches a lot. Truly, I think it was that matter of just not really having good nutrition. And I can feel such a difference in just adding this jar to my life every morning. And again, like with all of those other claims about like disease prevention, I saw in researching this, you know, the cholesterol thing, that's something that people talk about a lot. I even saw somebody say that it really, you know, juicing can help fight cancer. And I think that all of those claims could really probably, you could say that just about eating a lot of plant material and cutting out a lot of the bad stuff like sugar and trans fats and processed foods. I think that really the person that I think that most benefits from juicing is the person who's having a hard time with a healthy diet for whatever reason. You know, I see a lot of people doing Whole30. I actually really like Whole30. I think it's a really good diet plan for cutting out the junk and getting back to real food. It does require a lot of planning though. For me, like with juicing, it might be an option for someone who doesn't feel like they have the capacity to plan out all of their meals that way. Maybe doing something like a juice cleanse would just make it simpler. And the other thing is, for like Jeremiah was all those years ago, he didn't like vegetables, he was really picky. And so this was just an opportunity for him to be able to get all those nutrients that he was depriving his body of. Sometimes it'll come up whether like juicing and making smoothies, like blending, are equivalent. And essentially, juicing does remove that fiber, and therefore it is allowing your digestive system the rest, whereas blending does not. The fiber is in. Also, as far as nutrients per ounce, it's going to be more concentrated in juice because you're putting more material into this glass rather than if you blend the same ingredients, because the pulp's remaining in, it would make multiple glasses. So it, as far as like the nutrition, this is more concentrated nutrition that does have the fiber. There are a lot of juicer options out on the market. I'm going to talk to you today about these two. These are the only two that I've really used, so they're the only ones that I can really comment on. Not sponsored by either one of these people. We paid for both of these juicers. This was our first juicer. This is a Breville juice fountain, and it's the one that he used on Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. That's why we bought it 7 years ago. It's held up all these years. We have used this thing a lot, and it's still working, but we did buy a new one, and I'll get to that. This is a centrifugal juicer, which means that when you turn it on, it spins this little screen thing in here that has these little teeth on it, and it shreds the produce, and it shoots all of the pulp over into this side and then spills all of the juice out here. Now, because it shreds, it's really fast. It goes really fast. It's really loud. And it extracts well. It's not as good for like leafy green things. You can run kale through it. I always had a really hard time with spinach and running kale through it. We just bunched it up and would press it down in, and it would do okay. The downside of this is that because it's shredding the produce, it's putting air in, so you get a lot of foam. And also, being that that air is introduced to the juice, it's gonna break down faster. So like the juice from this is best when you drink it right away. It actually, like, over the course of like a day of being in the fridge, it gets a lot darker. The flavor really degrades. Kind of like if you leave an apple out on the counter, it gets brown. It does that because it's introducing all of that air. I think the price point of this one is like between $150 and $200. They have smaller models that are like quicker to go. So the benefit is it's a little cheaper, it's faster, has this really wide feed chute, so you don't have to prep stuff nearly as much. Like, you can run a couple of carrots and a couple of stalks of celery through here at the same time, and it's gonna tear through it. So it juices really fast, but it's really loud. Sounds like a leaf blower. It's really loud. You're not gonna do this early in the morning without waking the kids up. I mean, it's just a really loud appliance. And the other thing is, it's a pain in the butt to clean. That screen, all these different parts, there are all these nooks and crannies. You really gotta get in there and clean. So we actually ended up buying this juicer because we did not like some of those things. Not being able to juice ahead of time because the juice was gonna break down. And the noise bothered me. I dealt with it for a long time. Some of you people who are not super like sensory will have no idea about that. But those of you who are, you get me. Even just turning it on right then, I'm like, oh, I don't like that. So we bought this one. This is an Omega, and I will link both of these down below. This one is a lot more quiet. This is a masticating juicer. See, it's a lot quieter. And the way this one works, it has a much smaller feeding chute, which means that you do have to prep this a little more. Typically what I do is I start running it, I get my cutting board there with my produce, and I just start cutting it as I'm feeding it in. So more prep work involved here. It basically is like a pressing of the juice instead of shredding it. It's got this auger right in here, and then this little screen that strains it out. And so basically the juice falls out here and the pulp falls out here on the end. This does take a little bit longer because you have more prep work, and also the smaller feeding chute means you're having to put pieces in. It's a slower process. It's a lot faster to clean. And the benefit of this is being that the juice is cold pressed, it's not shredded, it doesn't have all that air added, and so it's good for up to 3 days in the fridge. That is the main reason why we went ahead and purchased this one. It was about $279, so definitely more of an investment than the Breville, but I liked the idea of being able to juice for a few days, like before I went out of town, and that's what I've done. When I go out of town, I'll take a cooler with a few days worth of juice in it, and I just do it all before I leave, and I don't have to worry about carrying a ton of produce with me, filling up somebody's fridge with produce. I don't have to worry. There are pros and cons to both of these. Jeremiah actually still prefers to use the Breville because he likes the fact that it's faster. However, he doesn't like the flavor of juice at all, and he just chugs it, whereas I'll actually drink it with a straw. I actually think it tastes really good and enjoy it. Again, I like vegetables and he doesn't. So I think that the breakdown of the flavor with the Breville doesn't bother him because he thinks it's all bad, whereas I taste a notable difference in the cold pressed juice versus the centrifugal juice. So that's kind of my opinion. I like both of them, still kept both of them. We still use both of them. But if I were going to buy another one, I would have stuck with the Omega. One of the main questions that we get asked is, how much does juicing cost? Now, obviously you are making an initial investment of buying a juicer, and then you've got to buy a ton of produce to run through it. In this jar, this 32-ounce jar, we do the same recipe almost every time. There are lots of juice recipes with lots of different benefits. However, this is our go-to. This is what we know to shop for. Sometimes, like when the garden is producing like beets and stuff, I'll run them through. Sometimes whenever I'll have like some extra cilantro after making salsa or something, I'll run that through. It's really tasty. You can run most vegetables through your juicer, but we do stick to this baseline recipe. We like it, and we basically do the same thing. Now, so in every jar that we do is one bunch of kale or spinach. We'll get a big bunch of spinach. Sometimes I'll be in a store and they'll have like bags of baby spinach or like bags of salad greens marked down super cheap, and I'll grab those and juice them instead. That's something you can do. Three stalks of celery, three carrots, a lemon, two apples, and a cucumber. That right there makes roughly 32 ounces of juice. And that is what we are each consuming every day. Now, I do try to purchase organic produce when I can. And at this point, I would say most of what I purchase is organic. However, it's another one of those things. Like, I had someone tell me once, they're like, well, if you're not going to purchase organic produce, what's the point of juicing at all? And it's that, again, that discouraging take of, well, what you're doing is not completely ideal, so you might as well just do nothing. And I absolutely disagree with that. I think that if all you can afford is the conventional produce, making juice every day out of this is going to be better than eating a fast food restaurant, because we think, well, we can't afford the organic produce, I can't make any steps to better myself. So I just wanna encourage you, do the best you can. Organic is better, obviously. That's going to be better if you can. Locally sourcing organic, even better. You know, like finding places where you can support sustainable farming. I am all about that. I say yes to that. But if those things aren't on the realm of possibility for you, just get the best that you can and do that. In order for me to make this, now I buy carrots in bulk, 5-pound bags. I buy organic kale because it's only about 10 cents more expensive. A lot of times I'll buy organic apples. I do try to get those organic. The lemons, I usually buy conventional, just because it makes a massive price difference. And the celery and the cucumbers, it really just depends. But to buy all of that stuff costs me roughly like $4. It's about $4 per jar of that juice making at home. If you were gonna go to a juice bar, you would probably pay something more along the lines of $15 for 32 ounces of juice. So if you consider purchasing food like this already made, you are saving a lot doing it yourself, but it is an investment. It costs more money to eat healthy, but in the long run, it costs significantly less. There are a few things not to juice, like bananas, avocados, mangoes are probably a little on the mushy side as far as juicing goes. I have seen people say that if you want to add like bananas or avocados into your juice to juice it and then blend that stuff in, of course you're gonna be adding fiber in. But if you wanna add the benefits of those fruits to your juice, just do it after the fact with a blender rather than putting it through the juicer. Anything that's really soft like that, it's not gonna work. It's gonna gum up your juicer. It is a time commitment. I probably spend around 40 minutes a day juicing, and that's usually for the morning and the evening, like standing there and going through it. And I've gotten it down now where I start cutting, pressing things through, dumping the pulp. That brings me to the pulp. One of the things that comes up a lot is people say, I hate the waste. Because when you run all of these vegetables through, this is gonna fill up with that jar of 32 ounces of juice, but this entire container is gonna fill up with pulp. Now, it used to really, really bother me to take that pulp and dump it out into the compost bin. Every day when I lived in town, it doesn't bother me so much now because I'm giving it to pigs and chickens and they're making me eggs and pork. And so it doesn't feel like a waste to me. However, putting it in the compost is definitely gonna build soil for your garden later on. And I don't really view it so much as waste because I got what I was wanting out of those vegetables. However, I have seen that people have dehydrated it to make like a seasoning powder that they put in things. I've not done that because with as much as we juice, that would be a lot of seasoning powder. And I've also seen where people have baked it and like into like almost a cracker. So there are options as far as using that pulp, or feeding them to your animals is definitely something that you can do and not feel so wasteful. That's kind of my comprehensive overview. I don't want to make this video just overwhelmingly long. If you have any questions, put them down below. I'll do my best to answer them. I'm not a nutritionist. I'm not an expert. I am just a girl that loves to garden and really believes in eating real food that has experienced a lot of benefit from using this tool in my life. I literally make my juice in the morning and sit down with it, and I feel excited inside because I know how good I'm going to feel. I'm so glad to have this as part of the routine. Sometimes it's hard to motivate myself to be like, okay, I'm gonna go make this juice, or oh, I've got to go to the store and get the stuff. Like, it, a lot of the things that we need to do that are good for us, they require extra effort, but to me, it is time and money well spent because I believe that our overall health is going to be just greatly benefited from this real food diet. And juicing has just been massively helpful to us in reaching those goals. I hope this helps you. I hope that it inspires you. And again, I just want to encourage you not to be discouraged. Just do what it takes. Make these changes. If you've got the habits, if you've got the sugar habits, if you've got the fast food window habits, don't feel condemned by this. This could be an opportunity for you to fuel your body, to set that baseline for what feeling good actually feels like. And I just want to encourage you to do that, to make the investment in yourself and just take charge of your health. So thank you guys again for hanging out with me, and I bless you until next time.